Good evening, everybody, and thank you for joining us on the web. This is Gil Leyvas up in Sky 5 along with my pilot, Jim Pollard. We are over a high-speed chase that started in the Lomita area. Sheriff's Department went into pursuit of this vehicle, wanted for felony once. The headlights just came on the vehicle. The vehicle was blacked out here for quite a while on the freeway. We're westbound 91 freeway in Cerritos, coming up to the 605 freeway. California Highway Patrol picked up the pursuit as it was in the South LA area on surface streets. The vehicle ended up getting on the 10 freeway eastbound from the downtown LA area, headed 60 freeway eastbound all the way out to the 57. That's when the vehicle turned south on the 57 to the 91 here and went west. So here we are, westbound 91. The speeds have been, like you're seeing there, 100 miles an hour. Night sunlight of the police helicopter overhead, keeping track of it. The ground units have pulled back. They're in surveillance mode. We're clocking it at somewhere around 100. And between 100 and 110, he's hitting the brakes. He's got some traffic here as we approach the interchange. It's moderate traffic right now, westbound. If he continues in this direction, he'll be heading back towards the Lomita area where the pursuit first started. Fortunately, the driver put his headlights back on here. Goes all the way across lanes, cutting off that truck. Traffic. Yeah. Hundred and seven miles an hour. We're tracking it. He's in the carpool lane, westbound 91. Here he goes out of the carpool lane, across lanes at Paramount. You see Paramount coming up here, and the vehicle not slowing down at all, going in and out of traffic. Oh, shoot. All the way across lanes. Might be taking that transition onto the... Oh, look at that. Hard on the brakes. That might have been a spike strip that took him out. It looked like there was a CHP that was in the center divider lanes. Here comes the rest of the units here. As he's exiting the freeway, we might see a pit maneuver at the end of this off-ramp. Unknown if it was a spike strip or not, but he was hard on the brakes there, hitting the brakes. A lot of smoke, and it looks like his front tire is popped. It looks like that was a spike strip. He's going to stop under the trees here. That's going to do it. They got him blocked in. Big rig there helping out a little bit to stop it. And he's trying to move on. He's going to move past them. Oh, look at that move. Went around the big rig. I think the front tire has been punctured. They might do a pit maneuver right here. Trying desperately to get into a position where they're going to do the pit. Here comes the street. Here comes a right turn. That car is smoking. Let's see if the pit happens right there. Nope. He's going to hit the gas. He's got enough under him to go. He's northbound here on Avalon. And look at the tires smoking there. The front tires are smoking. So it looked like that was a successful spike strip. He's down to the rim on that front driver's side. That's why you're seeing that smoke. Here comes the CHP unit to try to do a pit maneuver. Trying to find the right spot, the right position. A little too fast, 60 miles an hour. They might still try. We'll see what happens. The driver Yep, there it is. He tries to take him out, hard on the brakes, and he's going to go through that intersection. He might be thinking twice now to keep going because that spun him out of control a little bit. But he's continuing here on Sam on Avalon. Once again, CHP coming up to get into position for that pit. Still up high speeds, though, and that unit having to hit the brakes. We're getting into some fog here, but the car is continuing on Avalon northbound, away from the 91 freeway. A lot of smoke coming up from those front tires. Oh, there goes one tire from the passenger side, rolling down the street. Here comes a CHP. One more time. We try to get in tight for this. He's going to set up for a right turn here, maybe. Nope, he's going to go through that intersection. Red light, dangerous situation there. Wow. That was Rosecrans. Okay, so wide enough street. No traffic to speak of, no pedestrian traffic. Here comes the CHP to try again, and he's going to go right up to him, but not quite to the spot. Look at the sparks coming off the tires. He's lost that, I believe it's the front tire that he lost on the passenger side. Pumping the brakes, hard on the brakes, got an intersection coming up. Major intersection, red light. He's going to go through it. Oh, no, look at that. Luckily, that vehicle saw it coming. Here comes the pit. Oh, there's a bright light there. And nope, couldn't do it there. Couldn't get into the right spot. A lot of smoke still coming off it. Wrong side of the road. Wow, desperate to get away here. Around a bus. Continuing on Avalon. Another red light, multiple red lights this car's been running. Look at the bumper, look at the rear bumper. It's peeled off a little bit after that first attempt on that pit maneuver. Unfortunately, he's in now in LAX's airspace. We can't get right up alongside of him. That CHP desperate, wanting to get that pit maneuver in the right conditions, the right spot. The driver just going a little too fast for that. I believe it just crashed into a vehicle and he's continuing though. Avalon in 98. I think it crashed, Jim. It may have stopped. Away for a minute here on the web. Thank you again for joining us on the web. We've gotten permission to get into the airspace now that the pursuit has ended in a crash with another vehicle, but also we're learning now that the vehicle also struck a pedestrian, which is very concerning at this point. We don't know the condition of that pedestrian. It was at 80th Street and Avalon where that pedestrian was struck. Here's the vehicle crashed into a corner, 73rd and Avalon. It ended up crashing into a fence up the street here. We'll come out wider to show you. Up the street here is going to be where the car hit another vehicle, we believe, right there. We see fire trucks rolling there, and then there's more activity here. Yes. We're going to move down. Here's the termination point of the pursuit. Driver in custody. They have a rescue ambulance on scene for that driver. You see him there on the ground. We're going to go down and look at the crash. He is in cuffs. He's on the ground there. See, in front of that CHP unit, we're going to go down. Avalon here, the fire department rolling south. And we'll see the two other locations. Here's Manchester and Avalon, and that's where the vehicle was struck. Okay, so Avalon and Manchester is where the collision with the vehicle happened. Further down the road here, though, let's see, fire department's... Fire department's clearing the scene here, but there are officers here in the street, in the northbound lanes. First and Avalon, it looks like this may be where the pedestrian was struck. There's an object in the road there. The fire department cleared the scene here. The officers are still there in the street. They're going to obviously block off the road here as evidence for the pursuit. Not sure what that item is there. We'll stay wide just so that we don't show anything graphic. I think we'll be able to see in the back, maybe, or maybe not. Let's see. If it's lit, we will. All right. Let's get a better shot of the car because we only got a passing look at it. Huh? No, this one into the fence.